This is a video for Patsy Conroy, who is turning 90 this year. I was thinking, since we can't all come to you and have a huge celebration for your birthday, that we would at least send you videos of us talking about memories and different things, and you could see what we're up to. So I still can't believe you're going to be 90. Do you realize that 48 years ago I met you? You were only 42 years old when we met. And look at us now. Not a day older, right? We look just as marvelous. Anyway, I just wanted to say happy birthday to you and talk about how nice it's been to have you in my life and remember some funny things, funny memories, like the time I was trying to get you to the airport in Tallahassee and you had Chico with you. Only problem was you had a health certificate that had expired. So when we got to the airport, the man said you couldn't put him on the plane because it had expired. So I called on the phone and found a veterinarian that would do his physical. So we ran over there and got the physical, and then we went home for the night. I'm sure we drank a glass or two of wine. And then the next day I took you back to the airport. So we got to the airport and we checked you in and we checked Chico in, and the man forgot to ask for the paperwork, and you pulled the paperwork out of your purse and handed it, put it on the counter. And I looked at it and realized that it said it was a female Cocker Spaniel, and he's a male wire-haired terrier. So I grabbed the paper and you said, no, you have to show it to the man. And I said, no, you don't. You need to put it in your purse. He didn't ask for it. And then I showed it to you and you looked at it and you said, well, this is the wrong one. And I said, shh, just be quiet and get on that airplane. So we finally got you on the airplane, and when we got you to security, you went through the gate by the security and turned around and yelled, thank you so much, thank you so much. And I said, that's okay, keep going. And then you said, what would I do without you? I'd still be in a bathtub in Italy if it wasn't for you. And the security man stood there and looked at you and looked at me, and the look on his face was priceless. And I looked at him and said, don't ask. And with that, you got on the airplane. So that's one of our fond memories. Although the memory in Italy kind of is fond as well, I guess. I had fallen asleep on the bed because we had to share a room, and all of a sudden I heard this little, Odie, Odie, Odie. And finally I woke up and went into the bathroom and said, what? And you said, I can't get out of the bathtub. So with that, I turned around and I fireman carried you out of this clog bathtub that was up on a pedestal, and I pulled you out of the bathtub and dragged you into the bedroom and plopped you on the bed. That's a picture not too many people need to witness, I think, but that was kind of funny. Our Italy trip, though, was really a lot of fun, and I enjoyed it. We also took trips on a bus through the New England states. I don't know if you remember that, but we went through 13 New England states. And we got a reputation because Patsy was always late to the bus, or she forgot which bus we were on. So all the passengers in the bus were always looking out for Patsy to make sure she got on the bus. That was a lot of fun too. So we've had some fun times, although we almost missed the bus in San Francisco. We went to the pier on the bus, and the bus was pulling away by the time I got you situated so you could get on the right bus. So I must say, you have been a delight at times. And turning 90 is quite a feat. So I hope you have a wonderful birthday. And I hope you enjoy every moment of it. And maybe you'll make it to 100, and then we'll all get together and have a huge celebration. The other thing is that this year, you know, I got married, and you already met Charlie. And Charlie was here when Summer graduated from nursing school. And you, I'm sure, had conversations with him and remember him. But just think, we have another nurse in the family. We just have a huge line of nurses. So we're all wonderful, caring women, don't you think? So with that, Charlie has to come over here and say happy birthday to you too.
Happy birthday, Miss Patsy. Happy 90th, and have many, many more.
So happy birthday, Patsy. We love you, and we hope you have a wonderful day. Mwah.
Happy birthday, Momsie. Welcome to you this morning, this great day that you were born. I'm so glad that you're part of my life. I couldn't be more blessed to have you in my life. One of the most special things you ever did was when I first met you is you sent me little angels. And you did that for many, many years. And I just want you to know how much it meant to me. And I wish you a wonderful, wonderful year. Know that we love you. Bye.
Happy birthday, Grandma Patsy. I still think about when we came to visit 10 years ago for your 80th birthday and how much fun that was. I know you're going to have an amazing year and I hope to visit you soon. Bye.
Hi, Mother Patsy. How are you today? I just want to first off thank Sean for putting this all together today and making it possible for us to join you with your 90th birthday. What a wonderful celebration. I'm very happy to be a part of this family, and I'm so grateful for the Conroy name itself. I want to wish you the happiest birthday possible because you are such a loving and wonderful, caring lady. Thank you very much and have a wonderful day. Goodbye now.
Hey, Nana, happy birthday. You're going to be 90. Well, I figured because it is my birthday and I turned 30, the glorious 30, today, that it was the perfect time to take a video of how happy I am that you made it to 90, even though I think 2 years ago you were telling me about how, yeah, you know what, it's about that time, about time to roll it out. I think I told you then, I told you now, I bet you're going to live to 90, and I expect you to live to 105 now since you hit the 90 mark. Life's been going great. I am getting ready to move to North Carolina, living up here in D.C. Weather's beautiful. It's hot. Middle of summer, that's how it goes. And my favorite thing about you, you have always had some awesome conversations with me. I've gone over there and we've sat there and chatted and talked. And that was awesome every time I got the opportunity to sit there and pick your brain. You're opinionated, you have ideas, and I just love the fact that I could sit there and have a long, drawn-out conversation on a multitude of topics many years that you and I have had those at the rare occasion that we've actually been able to get together in the same spot in the same place. And then it was always fun to sit over there and eat barley soup and watch movies with you also. Old classic movies that sometimes were as awesome as you say they were, and sometimes they were okay. They're okay movies, but hey, they're classics. They're better than the new stuff. Yeah? Awesome. Love you, and I hope you have a wonderful 90th birthday.
Happy birthday, Nana. I love you.
Happy birthday, Nana.
I say I love you.
I love you. Mwah.
Say happy birthday. Say chunk-a-munk.
Say happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Yeah, I'll put that down, buddy. Hey, Holly, you gonna blow a kiss? Lucas?
Hello.
Kelly, you gonna blow a kiss?
I love you.
Say happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
thought I'd make you a little video of us California folk, just to prove that we're not a bunch of sissy yuppies. There's no city folk around here, so I got my 300 Win Mag, and I'm gonna shoot 300 yards and prove that I can hit a target. So here we go. Bullseye. Now here's Carter with an AR-15.
Hey, Grandma, how you doing?
All right, Carter.
Bye.
Bye, Grandma.
Happy 90th birthday, Mom. We're all so fortunate to have you at such great health at such a ripe age. I can't believe you're 90 years old. I can't believe I'm 63 years old. But it's pretty cool. I wish we had some grandkids to show you, but on the next video, we'll have something to show you. So this bench is kind of was a fun thing to do. It was Dad's idea to build a bench for people like this that come and put their roller skates on or put their running shoes on. And he wanted me to build a bench for them. I didn't really build a bench for them, but I did build a bench on Dad's behalf. It was his idea, so I put his name in it. And I had to definitely put my brother Dan's name in it. So it was fun to build. I thought about them the whole time I was building it. So happy birthday, and we'll talk to you later. So this coming week, we're going down to visit John Joe. He's having a family reunion at his beach house in Stinson Beach. And his sister Kitty is coming out with her two kids, which are now both medical doctors. And last time I saw them, they were in diapers. And now they're full-grown medical doctors, so it'll be fun to meet them again. And it's actually on your birthday, so we'll send you some pictures of that. So we miss you. We'd like you to come out maybe Thanksgiving or whenever you feel like it. If you're up to it, let me know.
Hey, Nana, we're in Alabama four-wheeling and wanted to wish you a happy 90th birthday.
Happy birthday.
Love you.
Hey, Nana.
Say bye-bye.
Bye.
Hey, happy bye-bye. Birthday.
You ready? Oh, wow. Book time. Book time.
Book time!
This is a book my Nana used to read to me when I was little. Walking with Nana. Who's that?
That.
Nana.
Nana.
And Mommy.
Mommy.
That's Nana and Mommy.
That.
Nana.
Nana.
I like to walk with Nana. Her steps are short like mine. She doesn't say, now hurry up. She always takes her time. I like to walk with Nana. Her eyes see things like mine do. Wee pebbles bright, a funny cloud, half hidden drops of dew.
That's good too.
Most people have to hurry. They do not stop to see. I'm glad Mama. That God made Nana a rushed Mama. And young like me. Mama and Nana.
Mama. Nana.
Nana.
Good job.
Nana.
Nana.
Say, love you, Nana.
Nana too.
Love you, Nana.
Nana.
Yay.
Nana,
love you.
Hey, Nana. It's Ryan. I just wanted to wish you a happy 90th birthday. It's pretty exciting. I wish I could have been there for your big day, but I'm over here in Seattle, which is pretty far from Kentucky, and I've been a little bit busy getting settled in here in Seattle for my new job. So kind of want to show you a little bit around Seattle, my new home. This is a view from my office. That's the Puget Sound. This is my kind of little office. I spend a lot of my time here now. But yeah, so I just wanted to show you around what I do here. We finance a lot of the building. So I do just commercial real estate now. So I don't know if you're familiar with Amazon, but they're based out of Seattle, and we do a lot of projects for them. And so there's a lot of building going on, and so I've been really busy with that. It's been really exciting. Get to learn a lot about big real estate developments, kind of follow it. And similar thing that my dad did, so I have quite a bit of interest in it. It's been a lot of fun. Still kind of learning. I've only been here for about a month now, so I will follow up with a little tour of my new place next. Hello, Grandma. All right, I'm just got home and wanted to show you around my place. This is got a little bathroom here, and this is my kitchen right here, you can see. And then this is my small little bedroom that has an opening. And then kitchen. And I got a little living room. You can see in here. Table. And then this is my, you can kind of see, probably won't show up, but got a nice little view. Anyways, kind of wanted to show you around my new place here in Seattle. Now that you've kind of seen a little bit of where I'm living now and how I'm doing, I just wanted to get an update on how you're doing. I'd love to hear what you've been up to. It's been a while. I'll give you a call here pretty soon. If not, give me a call. And once again, I just want to say happy 90th birthday. It's pretty incredible. And looking forward to coming to visit you in Kentucky. All right, have a great birthday. Love you, Grandma. Hey, Nana. I'm out in the Washington forest. You can see it all. I'm out here working on the trails. The WTA stands for Washington Trail Association. So we're out here fixing the trails, we just moved this rock right here to block off some, so people don't go off the trail. But we're out here with a group of people trying to make this trail a little bit nicer. So if you can see, it's very green. It's pretty cool. There's a lot of ferns. Not a lot of sun comes through here. Yeah, it's a nice little hike. Get out of the city a little bit. It's only about an hour from my house. So you can see that it's real green. So fixing the drainage of the trail, and then making sure people don't get off the trail at all. So, yeah, happy birthday, Nana. Hope you have a great day, and I hope to see you soon. All right, see ya.
Hey, Nana. As you know, we're moving to Asheville. We've been studying all summer, and we're excited for you to come visit us.
Yes.
We're going to take our boards here soon, and then we're going to be physical therapists.
Woo-hoo.
Hopefully, if it all works out.
Happy 90th birthday, Nana.
Hey there, Nana. I'm trimming your bush. Not because I want to, but because I love you.
Hey, Inga, what's your favorite thing about Nana?
Oh, that's easy. I would say my favorite thing about Nana is her sense of humor. She's pretty funny, and I think that's where I got my sense of humor. So I hope when I'm 90, I have a great outlook on life and a great sense of humor just like her.
Hello, Auntie Patsy. Happy 90th birthday from your old niece. You must have been only 17 when I was born, so you and I have grown old together. And hasn't it been quite the trip? So what have I been up to? Well, I think you do follow me on Facebook more or less. You probably have a good idea already of what I've been up to. But I've been happily retired from the medical field for several years now, and I'm much relieved about that. I find that tending and caring for plants is much less stressful than caring for humans, because if your plant dies, It's unfortunate if you lost your tomatoes, but it's not the tragedy that it would if your patient dies. So since then, I started the community garden in our area, and I continue to work hard at that, particularly physically, hauling a lot of manure and mulch. I'm the manure madam for the garden. I am the secretary of the board for the Unitarian Universalist Fellowship, and I continue quite active in that. I do a lot of social justice work. And I have become a bit of an environmentalist, and since the election, a bit of a political activist. I spend a fair amount of time checking in with Naomi and doing for her, and I feel very privileged to continue to have her as part of my life at 96 and a half. And it looks like you will be following in her footsteps the way you're going. Good for you. Let's see, memories. One memory that stands out is when at the age of, I guess I was about 40, in 1985, Dan and I had divorced at that time, and I received a letter from you of support saying that, well, Nana, you did get your kids up into your teens. They were about 14 and 16 at the time, and the attitude was very supportive and non-judgmental, which I really appreciated at that time. Another earlier memory is when we lived in Atlanta and you and Lorena came for a visit. I was about 14 and very conscious of my body. And I remember watching Lorena run around and thinking to myself, and I think I even said to you, gee, what a tiny butt she has. And I was very envious of that. We don't have a lot of memories because you all lived on the other side of the continent from us. I wish we had been able to spend more time together. I know that King used to mix our names up all the time. I was Patsy, and you were Nana, just like you are with the rest of your family. And I know that he would be very happy to be part of your birthday celebration were he here, and maybe he's kind of floating around somewhere for all you know. After all, my mother said he did make a quick trip through the car after his death, letting everybody know he was okay. So one never knows, I guess. Let's see, I know Naomi wishes you a happy birthday, although she deferred from making a video. Like me, she has become very conscious of how one looks as one ages. Just sometimes not doesn't create happy feelings, but it's better than the alternative, certainly. And I wish you a great celebration with your family and hope to see you again before too long. Happy birthday, Aunt Patsy.
Hey, Nana, happy 90th birthday. I hope you have friends and family around you and you're having the best time ever. We miss you and have a great day.
Hey, Nana, happy birthday. I'm out here in the main streets of Las Vegas, or Dad would call it Lost Wages. Actually, I'm about 15 minutes from my house at the Red Rock Canyon. It's pretty cool. The strip's kind of silly, but once you get off the strip, there's a lot of wide open desert out here, place to explore. So here's some video of us going exploring in my new vehicle, care of Great Uncle Pat.
I give you a call.
Just wanted to say how lucky and thankful I am that I got to grow up out on Dandy Hill with Nana and Grandpa John helped raise me, along with my parents, of course. And raising animals and watching old movies and living out in the woods, probably the best childhood setup I could imagine. And then later on in life, when I got to drop out of society as a grown man and play music in your barn for a year or two. That was pretty amazing. Thank you for that. And nowadays I get to call you on the first of the month to support my sponsorship and come visit you. But I'm glad you made it to 90, Nana, even though you bitch about it. You're going strong for 105. I don't think you have a choice. So I hope you enjoy these videos. I thought it was pretty crazy that everyone's in all these different states all spread around, but they're all thinking about you and they're all appreciating you. And yeah, I appreciate everything you've done for me. I'll come visit you and I'll talk to you soon. Love you, Nana. Happy birthday.
Hey, Nana.
Happy birthday. Nana.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
No.
We love you.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Nana. Happy birthday to you.